Welcome to this presentation of Autodesk Revit Architecture 2010. My name is Rabi Sidawi. The focus today is to work on orienting a 3D view to a 2D view and therefore creating a 3D detail. This happens to be one of the best kept secrets of Revit, and it's kind of sometimes hard to remember how to go back and use this after a long time. So we'll start off by creating a call-out view. We will focus our attention to this particular area in the plan, which shows us a couple of windows. And then I'm going to switch to the 3D view of the building. And apparently this doesn't have a roof on, so we'll go ahead and start to create this roof. And by creating a roof, we were able to capture the edge of the roof as part of the 3D detail. I'm going to go ahead and use the roof by footprint and place the roof on level 2, create an overhang of 2 feet for this building, and with some keyboard shortcuts I'm able to capture all of the roof overhangs at the same time, and voila, here's our roof. We will go ahead and also maybe add some structural foundations to this building. I'm gonna go with the wall foundation and simply do that simultaneously. And what this will do, it will create these foundations for us, as you can see here. Then we'll go ahead and generate this 3D detail. We will do that by creating a simple orientation of the 3D view. So we will orient it to the detail that we had earlier. And by doing that, we were able to generate this 3D detail very quickly. Turn this around, of course. And now that the focus is on this detail, I'm going to maximize the view, change the scale of the view maybe to about 1/2 inch equal 1 foot. And since this is a parametric detail, where this is, I'm going to tweak the section box so that I'm able to see the foundations below as well as the roof above. Now that we have this detail, we were able to go ahead and hide the section box, add our annotations, and we will be done with this particular detail. One of my favorite tools in this view is the spot elevation command, which allows us to capture parametrically some of the things that we need in the model, such as the sill height, the head height of the building, and any other information that that may be important, such as the top of the footing. So apparently this moved slightly, so I'm going to move it back. And of course adding text is should be a breeze, so we can simply go ahead and do that by calling out specifically certain components. Like so, and so this is makes up the basis of that particular detail, and we can continue to annotate this, and if we have to, we can export this to a drafting view and continue to add more detailed components on that. Thank you.